Ooh. Ready, cue music. Cue music.
I'm Mary Jane, and these are my co-hosts, Deanna and Seth. That one's Deanna, and this is Seth. Hi. It's nice to have you here tonight. We're all enjoying ourselves here, watching little TV with you all. You guys ready for some great shows?
Yeah, I think we've got an exciting night planned for you.
I think so,
this is unfortunately our last show of the season.
Season finale! Woohoo!
Yeehaw!
Get excited!
Right, Seth? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, we're all getting naked after the show in preparation of Naked Mile. So,
well, is that before or after we drench ourselves in champagne?
I think it should be before.
Yeah.
To kind of heighten the experience.
Yeah.
A little
oh
bit.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. You know, bubbly stuff on your body is nice.
So, did either of you go to Hash Bash this last weekend?
I walked through the
diag.
Yeah.
Just, you know.
So I think that qualifies.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, I was feeling a little nice when I came out of the diag that day.
Yeah, pretty
smart. Of course,
smart.
I walked really quickly, just so that nothing would happen to me.
You beat it on through.
Yeah, I didn't want to get corrupted in any way, shape, or form. It was so damn crowded, though, that walking quickly was a snail's pace.
I think the biggest number of things at Hash Bash are dogs. Like, everybody takes their dog to Hash Bash.
And I wonder how the dogs feel about that.
I think they like it.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, they like it a lot.
Yeah, well, if I had a dog, I think I'd take him to Hash Bash, too, even though I've never had a dog, because my mom hates them, because they poop on the all over the place, and she doesn't want to deal with that. I have a cat, though.
Yeah? What's
just
its name?
Bad. Well, its name
Row.
Is Buttercup, but, yeah.
Row. Row.
I call it, you little... Wait, I would take her to Hash Bash, though. That'd be nice. See my cat high?
Oh. I wonder if this is Hash Bash. No? Oh, this is,
swing dancing music.
Third Rock.
Oh.
Row!
I have not seen this show in a while.
Row!
Amanda, I gotta go. Bye.
Oh, it's a made-for-TV movie? That looks like...
Hey.
It looks like Fred Savage. No, it didn't. Never mind.
Isn't he like 50 by now?
Yeah. Have you seen pictures of him lately?
Mm-mm.
He looks weird. I mean, he doesn't look like Fred Savage.
He just looks like a roller with a long stick. Okay, obviously, there's something.
More performance tech now.
Oh. I hear this is a great show. I want to see it a couple times.
This intro is so funny.
Her eyeshadow is just amazing.
It's so rad.
I know. When I'm at 8, I'm gonna wear that much eyeshadow. You think she's hot? You dig her? You like that thing? Me too.
Now you gotta walk.
All day.
Beep.
Meow.
Do that again.
Special sleep for
baby.
Talking birds.
He watches television.
Okay, now why do they do that? They like, they focus the camera right on a woman's breast. Like in the opening.
Or
in the legs, yeah.
Because she can stop traffic.
And you know, the thing is, it looks normal when they do that. And I saw a commercial the other day that focused the camera on men's crotches, and it looked totally wrong. And you know, it's just like, it just doesn't look the same as when you like sexualize men on TV as you do women.
Speaking of male crotches,
yeah.
I've been thinking about the word gonad lately.
Gonad? Doesn't it just roll off the tongue?
Gonad?
Gonad. I never thought about it before.
Gonad. You can like substitute it in a lot of ways. So I was walking to the store, gonad. It works really well. I've just been working with it. I like the word. I like it.
Oh, wait. So wait. You were walking in the store. What do you use gonad in the context of?
He's a gonad.
He's a gonad?
Yeah.
And, like, is this a positive thing? Or?
It depends. If you like gonads.
I mean, I guess, like, is it like the F word? How it can be used in, like, a variety of different contexts?
No. It's not like that. It's got kind of a beauty to it.
Gonad?
Kind of a full-bodied sort of word.
Now, you know what? I think gonads are like a fifth gut. It's a word for, like fifth, not even, like, organs or anything, or like even anything to do with male crotches. It was like the digestive system organ. Like,
really?
Yeah. I don't know, but I guess like when you say gonad, the word nads in there. When you say nads, you think of, you know, nads.
Yeah. If you like gonads, feel free to give us a call here at 647-2641. Gonads.
On campus, 72641. You don't even have to dial the picture before.
Convenient.
I know. Around the store.
For those gonads, yeah.
Why not just write Pathetic Loser everywhere?
Obviously.
Any other broken dreams you're looking to sell? Perhaps an unopened box of condoms?
Do you like gonads?
I know you're familiar with American culture, but our customs dictate that I pop you in the mouth this time you say something like that.
I'm game. Although I must warn you, my screams can be quite
Okay, now I want you all to notice that our lucky slip.
I'm sure you're not We're bragging, sir, but unless you lipstick. Want to buy the engagement ring, I have to get back to work.
Well, let's see it then. You get engaged, sir? Well, for the weekend at least, although I sense we'll be growing apart by Sunday. I'm not selling
you
it to you. This means a lot to me.
Well.
I know, yeah. It's great for the last
Fine.
Show.
Then let
nice.
It be on your head that this poor woman slept with me and got absolutely nothing out of it.
He looks so pretty.
Here you go, pig.
You know, if you had green eyeshadow on, you could almost be that woman on the show.
We should try.
You always have to add because your girlfriend dumped you?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
We can do that later on if you
your
want.
You?
You know, he can't really do much about it. I mean, he's not saying much. I think we could just totally do something.
Oh,
you know, I've always wanted to do that to, like, one of those British guards who just can kind of stand there and their job is not to talk. Like, what if you were to go up to them with this, like, a whole bucket full of makeup and say, here, like, start, yeah, just start playing with them. I mean, I wonder, like, what they do.
Donuts.
Go ahead. yeah, or...
I think green is definitely
like,
color.
Go up to them and say gonads or something. Say green. I think green and blue both, like, green on one eye and blue on the other.
Yeah.
Hey, Drew.
Hey. Hey, Drew, we're going to lunch. You want to come?
Do you guys watch the show a lot?
Yeah, I'd love to, but I have to
nah.
watch. So you guys go ahead without me.
I think I've just seen, like, one of them. Oh, is he a sheep?
When you borrowed my super glue, is this what it was for?
Yeah.
That was nice.
Sorry I'm late, Drew. I got your call on my pager. I got here as soon as I could. What's the problem?
Oh, Sharon, I'll be right with you. My friends are just about to leave.
Oh, I get it. You got work to do. With the handyman.
Excuse me.
I guess Drew got to tell you what to do with yourself.
All right. We could use a caller to...
Excuse me, do you think you're hiding?
Pardon? Anybody watching?
Yeah.
You know, this is your last chance to call us. We're not going to be on anymore.
No,
and, I mean, there's only one life, and... If you don't call Slant today, and you're not going to live in a dorm next year, you're not going to have a chance to do this ever again. Just think about it. So, I mean, call now while you still have a chance, man. I mean, live life to the fullest.
Oh, you know how long it takes those guys to get
here. This is serious.
Hey, Mr. Carey.
It's sad. Like, actually, this is my last year in the dorm, and I'm pretty depressed about it.
Work through it. Work through it. If you want to talk, open forum.
Yeah, man, I've got this triple room, and it's just great.
All that space.
Yeah, all that space, I can just spread out. It's amazing. And I'm just living here in, like, a house or something, and it's so cramped. And, I mean, I'm not going to know what to do with my own room.
Yeah.
It's so small.
Feel the pain.
You know?
Listen, the chair really is broken.
And, like, I'm not going to do the kitchen. I'm going to have to make my own food.
Oh.
Actually make a decision what about
Listen,
to eat.
Really?
Nice something stuff. Nutritious?
Before you try to guess where this is going, yes, I'm going to ask you out, but...
I didn't know that.
Only as a friend.
Seth?
Oh. So that's why the engagement didn't
work. Oh, really?
Sure.
Is something you want to talk about?
I always wanted a gay friend.
Call her Seth?
Hey, okay, look at me. I'm not in that kind of shape.
Okay, never mind.
You just want to be friends?
So, yeah, Seth,
are you dealing with some issues you want to talk about?
Me, I won't fall in love with them. You know, no pressure.
Silence, Seth.
Just two friends out having fun.
Friend, huh?
Yeah.
Want to talk about this over lunch?
Yeah, but I got to warn you, I don't talk much while I'm eating.
Give me a moment while I try to react with surprise.
Hey, you're funny. You like flowers? Come here.
I think Drew Carey's so funny looking.
Easter egg's gonna be a drag.
What was he on before? Like, was he one of those Saturday Night Live people? What did he do? I don't remember.
I don't know. I forget. Like, he looks so familiar, doesn't he? What do you think? Like, do you remember Seth?
Do you want to talk about it, Seth?
More painting, less talking, okay? If we don't get these over to Reverend Linderman, there's gonna be a whole bunch of kids walking around the church lawn filling their Easter
baskets. He's cute in his own little way. He's got those glasses going on.
He's sort of like the little kid in Jerry Maguire.
Yeah, you're
only
right.
On a big scale.
Oh my goodness, or vice versa.
Yeah.
Oh, that is so true.
You're a little distorted.
Yeah, the
I
human
like
head weighs 8 pounds.
I'm really sorry.
That's so cute. He was the most adorable little kid I've ever seen.
He did rock.
That's my little brother. But that's another story.
Try drinking 6 feet behind your head.
The Jerry Maguire was an okay movie. It was all right. I mean, I don't know. I didn't really get as much from it as other people did. I like that song, Secret Garden, though.
Yeah.
I've never heard it before that movie either.
Bruce Springsteen isn't as good.
The boss
is Kiss.
Actually, you know what? Come to think of it, I've never heard a song by Kiss identified with Kiss. Seriously, like,
I don't think I have actually even now I think about it.
So they're just so like, image.
Yeah.
I have a boner right now.
Seth.
Hell with danger.
Oh yeah. Well, he's sitting between two gorgeous women. So of course. It's okay, buddy.
It's natural.
Okay. I read a statistic about that the other day.
About boners?
Yeah, like during the night, did you know that a guy has an average of, like, 4 a night?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I was gonna ask.
Isn't that interesting?
Is this true, Seth?
Is there something about me that puts guys off? I
at least.
Wow.
And he canceled.
Personally?
He said he had to work late.
It's okay.
Well,
you don't have
impressive.
To.
That's
tons of times. I can't tell you how many women I've gone out with that said they had to work late. Oh, so sad.
Time. I mean, I get canceled on, or I go out once and I never hear from the guy again.
Well, I don't know, you're kind of tough, but I like that. And it can't be your looks because you're really cute. I mean,
is this still Drew Carey?
Man, you're adorable.
Yeah, it's still. Hey, change the channel. Let's change the channel.
Something else.
Yes.
The baked potato.
That was weird commercial.
Who is this guy?
Swallows the owner.
What was that? What is this?
Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That was good.
Oh, cool. That's awesome.
Whoa.
Look at that. I would
heavy
really
breathing.
Like to go
scary.
To, like, a rainforest or something. That's one good thing about being in the military is you get to go to places like that.
Come on, it's fun.
Drew Carey again.
Who's that chick?
And the paint comes right out here on the paint pad.
Home right. This is like the beginnings of Home Improvement.
Easy it works. So right up
I really
wall,
would love to like
start
have
painting.
The knowledge to do things. Kind of like fixing your car. Yeah, like you should know. So
you know, I have a friend who works in an auto shop.
Yeah.
Yeah. She like that's where she learned to fix cars. I don't even know how she got the job. She just knew someone who knew someone who works in an auto shop and needed a person to do it. And she was a mechanic all year.
That's
you know, it's great. And now she can go around fixing people's cars.
Yeah.
And, yeah, she didn't get paid for it or anything, or she did get paid for it while she had the job, but, you know, now she knows how to change her own oil. And that's just something that a girl should know how to do. You know, it's really respectful.
Yeah.
Because I don't know anything about cars. Like, I open the trunk, and it's like a bunch of squiggly things made out of metal. And
include that. You mean the engine?
Yeah. That, I mean the
I
hood.
Yeah.
The trunk. The trunk hood.
It's okay. I'm
whatever.
With you. I'm with you. For like this.
Okay. Good. I don't even like. Isn't there a difference between like a rear engine? Is it called the trunk if you open up the rear engine? Is that the trunk or is that the hood also? Is the hood always in front? You know, that's a really deep question, huh?
I bet the hood is always in front.
And even though the trunk contains the engine, like in a Volkswagen Bug,
yeah,
like that's still the trunk, the engine in the trunk, not the hood. So, I don't know. What do you think, Seth?
How do you feel about the trunk hood debate?
He doesn't know either. Guys are supposed to know these things. I mean, this is the stuff. This is guy stuff. I'm disappointed.
You order. You buy shit. Don't
let your next painting project get you down.
Huh?
Introducing the Home Right painting system, featuring the innovative and easy to use Home Right paint stick.
Hey, look.
Attach the universal lid to any
hey, Seth, look.
Paint can. Place the paint stick
this
on
is
the
guy stuff, isn't it?
Handle, and you're ready to
paint all this hardware.
Square feet in just one stuff. Throw away those old rollers and paint pads. The paint stick gives you perfect one coat coverage each and every time. Attach the 3/4 inch.
Can you imagine owning your own house and having to paint it?
No, that'd be a crazy job.
I know.
I'm a little scared of owning my own house. Spatter shield. Those will come in handy.
The entire Home Right painting system is available through this special television offer for only 3 easy payments of $19.95.
But solid.
Today, you'll also receive the Quick Painter, designed to reduce the time of cutting in. This
you want it?
Glides around
oh, you're sold. You're so sold.
I wonder about the free gift that comes with it.
Yeah, the splatter guard.
Yeah, that's free for $5.95, yeah.
Oh, my bad.
Don't you love when they say, and for additional $3.95, you can get this free.
And so will cleaning up. That's right. Use this handy painter's tool.
Ooh, handy painter's tool.
Roller cleaner to
I could really use
faucet,
one of those.
And the roller cover is
yeah, tools are always handy.
Always.
Hi, Kevin. How's it going?
Good. How are you guys doing?
Good.
How are you?
I'm doing okay, I must say. I think you should stay away from the infomercials, perhaps. I must say, long-time watcher, first-time caller.
Nice. I'm glad you called because this is the last episode.
What would you like to...
Yeah, no, just this semester, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, that's, okay, yeah.
Hey, maybe. Kevin.
Yes?
What would you like to watch?
I'm always a fan of Drew Carey.
Oh, really?
We were on that a long time, though.
Of course, you know, truth be told, you can just keep the camera on, you know, that first girl and, you know, no, not him. I'm afraid I agree with the people from last week. He is a freak of nature. Get him off the air. Or have him say something.
Oh, take
off the lipstick.
Oh. You don't like it?
We're kind of like a lipstick family tonight. We're just trying to all be, you know, like that.
Consolidated team.
Yeah,
all
yeah.
That stuff.
Yeah, yeah. This is, we're matching.
Yeah, that's why. We're all in
it. You know, if you're going to do that, I mean, and don't think this is mean, because it might be construed as such, but I mean this is constructive criticism. Put the guy in the middle, put a bag over his head, then put the lipstick on the outside of the bag. Cut him some ear holes or eye holes.
Beautiful.
And maybe, just maybe, have him speak once in a while. I hate mimes.
Aww.
Because, you know what?
Oh, the he's not a mime.
I know where you live.
Seth, it's okay. It's okay.
Why did they write that in pink? What's that supposed to mean?
You figure it out.
Okay. Are you guys still watching the infomercial in the corner?
Well, right now we're actually at a commercial,
oh, okay.
I believe. If you'd like a... I think we can go to Carey, though, there.
I'm Drew Carey.
Oh, we are... I guess we are on Drew Carey.
Awesome.
Yeah, so...
You guys have some sort of, like, hour special, some pyrotechnics plan? Because, I mean... I'm going to be very disappointed, that you guys are not going to be on next week or the week afterwards.
Sorry, what are you going to do with yourself?
I'll probably watch the 9 o'clock show on CBC, to be quite honest.
Yeah. Well,
that's the only reason I don't watch the 9 o'clock show is because you guys come on at 9 o'clock.
Well, you know, you can also watch Drew Carey unfettered by our swaying viewpoints.
Hmm.
And Kevin, We'll be back next year for your viewing enjoyment.
But I'm not going to be here next year. I'm moving to London.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, it's nice in the fact that, you know, it's a change and all that, but it's going to be totally slantless.
Now, this is London.
I can tell.
Is it? Are you studying abroad?
Actually, I'm transferring.
To
London School of Economics?
Yes, I am.
No way.
I know somebody there right now.
Really?
But I haven't talked to her very much, so I don't know how she's doing.
Why? Did going away make her mean?
No, she was just more like a friend of a friend.
Oh, okay. So when I heard that a lot of people in London are really rude, but it's a clean city, so that's good.
Yeah. Pollution or stuff bad.
Yeah, that you have to take a shower like 3 times a day because, you know, as soon as you step outside, you get like all of your nutrients in one breath.
Hey, Kevin.
Yes.
Are you Canadian?
Maybe. Does that make a difference at all?
No, I was just wondering by the accent.
I did live there for a short period of time, actually.
Which province?
Ontario.
Oh, okay. Very cool.
I like
he
Canadians.
He is not Ontario. He's... What's wrong with his teeth?
Oh, he does Colgate commercials normally, so they're extra bright.
Oh.
Yeah. He's like, when you just see the mouth, it's him.
Okay.
He's a mouth model.
You know how you can improve the WOLV ratings supremely?
How?
Put the girl on the left on the air like 20 hours of the 24
oh
of the day.
Oh, my God, I'm so hurt.
You shouldn't be hurt, you know? At least you've got that guy in the middle to, like, kind of break it up a little bit, you know?
You're still not getting
anything. Is he wearing blush?
No. That's his naturally rosy complexion.
I'm sorry. He's a mime, and mimes are inherently scary.
Kevin?
Thank you for that camera angle. Oh.
Hey, Kevin?
Yeah?
We gotta get back to the show, but thanks for calling.
I understand.
Yeah, have a good night.
Have a good year.
Thanks, you too. Alright, so what are we at
here? Kevin was sweating you.
Me? I thought he was talking about you.
He's like, he's talking about you. Left.
Huh? Left. Oh.
Yeah.
Left and right.
Yeah.
Reverse.
Thanks. Yeah, I think he wanted Seth. I mean, seriously?
Secretly.
Yeah, that's what it seemed like. I mean, I think everyone wants Seth.
It's so cheap.
He loved your lipstick.
Yeah.
That woman that lifted the car up her child.
That sounded like Seinfeld for a second there.
Yeah, the way you said child.
Yeah, New York stuff. Now, if they had Seinfeld on tonight, oh, man.
All good.
So much you could do. But man, I wish I had watched Drew Carey more, but here it's a great show.
I wish my basement would get flooded so I could have a swimming pool.
That would be so cool. But my basement's been flooded before, and actually it
sucks.
It really sucks.
I bet it smells, like, eventually.
Oh, yeah. I live in the basement, so...
Oh, that's not fun.
I know. I don't live in the basement when it got flooded, but...
Holy crap!
Still is a little bit musty down there.
Have you ever lived in a basement, Seth?
Good, buddy. Can I get you a drink?
Is it fun? Was there a lot of sun?
Was it nice and cool in the summer and warm in the winter? That's the great thing about living in basements. But they're very, they're good temperatures. Ryan? Hey, Ryan, what's up?
Hello?
Hi, Ryan.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Jake? What's up? What are you doing? Hey.
Kind of busy, Drew.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Did that have to do with gonads?
Aren't lipstick marks distracting when you get them on your drink? Like, if someone has lipstick, yeah. If someone has that, like when you're at a party or something and someone drinks and they put lipstick on it, that's all you can look at.
Yeah.
Like, your eyes keep sifting through their glass. Oh, is Ryan still there? Or is he still breathing on the phone?
I think he was done flushing.
Anything quality to say?
That was so cool.
Funny.
Hey, I don't speak Spanish either.
It's still there?
You can also play carrot.
through?
What?
You don't want to just be friends anymore, do you?
No.
And oh, I thought they were together. They're not hooked up?
No.
And you haven't.
I thought they were getting it on.
A long time, have you?
I taught myself.
Oh, yeah.
This is really sweet.
I want to learn how to play the accordion. I mean, how cool would that be?
You're a real...
I don't know how to play the accordion.
Say nice guy.
You could get lots of polka gigs.
Hey, get lots of guys that way.
Hey, baby.
Guess what I can do?
I can play the accordion.
See if you felt the same way
of course,
that I felt.
That's not a problem, so.
I wonder if you'll believe I'm a lesbian looking in your face.
My entourage there.
Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to fix all this, and I'm going to do what it costs. We're not going to date.
Aww.
You asked for it. Ladies and gentlemen, Cherish.
All right, Drew, babe, you can call me, okay? What is that? Is that a boat? A dinghy?
Yeah, it's in the basement.
Oh, that's awesome. Don't you love when you go over to a friend's house or something and they have a boat, like in their garage or basement or something? I don't know if you all have ever experienced that, but I used to quite
never
often.
I've never seen it in a basement.
Actually, come to think of it, I haven't either.
That would
I just
rule.
Said it because there's a boat in the basement on the show.
After that, it's international waters.
Hello?
We used to have a friend. He built like one of those huge boats in his backyard. Built
yeah.
it.
But you know what's
and
really
like out of wood?
Big. You know, no, it was out of like all.
That was cute as hell.
I don't know.
Aluminum
stuff.
Like,
could you go to the hardware store and buy boat
really
materials or what?
If you did something like that for me, I would be yours forever.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was big. And, like, he could sleep on it and stuff. It was that big. I mean, he could like, hold
like
a party on it. It was a party boat.
Oh. Was it like flat or was it like that?
It had a hole and everything. I mean, it was like 30, 40 feet tall.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it was amazing. You had to climb a ladder.
My boner went away.
So if you have a boner, give us a call at 647-2641.
Yeah, last chance.
To open your boner.
Seven more lives will be saved.
Go, Ned.
By the end of the day,
it's back.
Will. These special filters will help make 25,000 more gallons of water ready for drinking.
Jeff,
what's up?
Hello.
How
you doing?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, I have a boner. Is that cool?
How big is it?
It's big. It's like a John Holmes size.
Have you ever measured
it? Yeah, that's bigger. Bigger. Yeah, there we go. 48 inches.
So you've measured your penis.
Very nervous.
Excuse me?
You've measured your penis.
Many times.
Do you have a name for it?
What was that?
Do you have a name for it?
Name for it?
Yeah. Like
I used to call it the pleasure stick.
Well, hey, baby.
I mean, like, some people, some guys, I've heard, like, 80% of guys have a name for their penis.
It's clear.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's like they call it, like, Elmo or something. I don't know.
My girlfriend got annoyed when I, you know, you call it that.
Well, did you say, hey, baby, want to ride the pleasure stick, or did you say, let's make love?
Well, it was like, you know, at first it was like, hey, baby, want to ride the pleasure stick.
Oh, see, there you go.
Number 33 to 1. Their leader, Armand de Green.
Well, yeah, hey, Jeff, we're about to end the show, so we got to let you go, man.
Down a hill,
good to hear about your pleasure stick.
Yeah, thanks for calling.
He smoked them with
I think you're our last caller of the semester.
If you will. History does not exist in a vacuum.
See you all next September.
Glenn will be back.
See you later.
Keep looking for us. Keep your eyes peeled.
Yeah, and watch lots of TV. It's good for you.
I love you.
Oh, I'm so excited.
You look glum today. What's the matter?
Well, every morning I wake up and stare into the black abyss that is my life.
You know, you should watch a little bit more WOLV-TV.
WOLV-TV?
Yeah, let me tell you about it.
WOLV, it's the station for me.
Yeah!
WOLV,
it's the station for me.
Everybody!
WOLV.
I watch the
lots
station
TV.
For me.
Are you guys the only two guys that work here?
Like, I'm only paid $5.75 an hour.
Me too.
Me too?
I just started at $5.75. The leagues that go on, which we have 300 teams playing right now, we'll have more in the...
Is there any objection to hiring Christine Young as our election director? Alrighty. Moving on to confirmation of election date. Back to Brian.
Sorry, Aaron. Thank you. Tentatively, we have set the election date for the 22nd, or Tuesday the 22nd, and Wednesday the 23rd of March. And the reasoning behind this is so that because of when all the filing deadlines and everything are, it does not conflict with spring break. Last year it was a week earlier, but there was a lot of problems because all the filing deadlines conflicted with spring break or midwinter break or whatever you want to call it. And so we've moved it a week later, or we'd like to move it a week later. So 22nd and 23rd is too much.
Second to the approval of the election date.
Second.
Is there any objection?
Object. You want to amend it?
Okay, there has been an objection, Brian.
I'll amend it that the, I'll make an amendment that the election date be contingent upon the approval of the election director, and the election director does not approve the date within before the next meeting, then we will reconsider the election date at the next meeting. And the reason I'm proposing this is that if for some reason that those exact days do not work with the work well with the election director's schedule, because we haven't discussed the dates with our new election director, that we could next week change the dates.
Is there a second?
Second.
Is there an objection? All right, is there any objection to the amended confirmation of election date? Alrighty, got that going. Moving on to number three, new business A to arbitration resolution. It is in. It's in your packet, but I think Meg wants to make a change from what's written before she moves it. So Meg.
To make this amendment more palatable to the majority of MSA representatives, under the first be it resolved, I'm scratching as final and putting in so long as AATU drops all of its lawsuits against MSA. So it will read, be it resolved that MSA agrees to enter into MSA-AATU arbitration at the Washtenaw Center for Dispute Resolution and will accept the decision of the arbitrator so long as AATU drops all of its lawsuits against MSA.
I'd like to amend that.
Okay, well first let's get a second. Is there a second on Meg's resolution?
Second.
Why do you have to second it? Because I'm changing it right now.
Well, no, aren't you just moved?
She's amending it before she's doing
right,
it.
Right, you amended it before you moved it. Right, so
yeah, she's entitled to do that.
Meg's official motion is what she just changed it to.
Yes, you don't have to second it.
Right, so Andrew second her amendment, her resolution. Sorry, her resolution.
However, Janelle has the right to
make
a suggestion at this time before she moved it.
Before she even moved it?
Yeah.
Okay. You can. She hasn't moved it.
What's my amendment is that, as Meg says, that the anti-retention team dropped the suits, and that also MSA resumed funding the anti-retention team.